Welcome everybody. Here we are at the facility of Chemnitz, and with me there is Christopher Schlegel, Research and Development Engineer in at Fraunhofer. So Christopher, we know Fraunhofer Institute, we know that you have a lot of winning case studies. Thanks to your research and development job. Can you mention something about that?
Yes. First of all, let me welcome you in our home, the Fraunhofer Institute IWU. Well, we are around 30,000 employees working for the Fraunhofer Gesellschaft, and most of them are trained in natural science and engineering, and produce around an annual budget of 2.9 billion euros. Two-thirds of this budget are mostly industrial projects or industrial and industry and publicity funded projects. And there's just one-third as a base fundament, which we get from the German federal and states. To have the possibility to invent things for the future, for the industry and society, what is crucial for the next years.
The soul of research and development, to look at the future. And do you remember when we started? When we started, the first idea was from the job of your colleague from Oak Ridge National Laboratories. And then we met in an exhibition. When? Don't you remember?
Yes, I remember very well. It was in 2017 when we met the first time at the JEC. We showed there our first experiments of the extrusion-based 3D printing and with granules. And there we met the first time. And from there on, we have a long journey going together. A lot of preliminary studies had to be done, a lot of discussions if our process meets the or gains the requirements for CMS. Yes, of course, it was a completely new technology for CMS at that time. And for us, it was the opportunity to take the next steps together and push the process to the next level.
We started with a 7 kg/h extruder. Now we are pushed to 10 kg/h. Without violating confidentiality agreement, can you say us some experience with this extruder and perspective also?
Yes, of course. Thank you for this question, Maurizio. Yes, as you can see in the background here, we combined our extrusion unit with its patented bypass system with six-axis parallel kinematic machine. It's so called hexapod. It's developed for very high building speeds up to 1 meter per second. But of course you could combine these extruders with a CNC controlled robot system, but which has a very high flexibility, but is of course limited in accuracy and speed compared to a CMS kreator.
Thank you. It is a numerical control machine center.
Yes. Maybe some special cases what we are doing. We develop special machines for the automotive supply industry, where we print on textiles, for example. We have just developed these machines, which are now in serious production, and the products have a very high accuracy requirements, just a few of hundreds of millimeters.
And now we are working, you know, at the biggest extruder,
yeah,
100 kilograms per hour, which are, in your opinion, the perspective of an application like that?
Okay, I think there are a lot of people who are waiting for even bigger machines, and also we see a great market there. If you imagine that the whole composite industry printing large laminating molds or vacuum molds to make it quicker and more cost effectively for printing these molds as in a traditional way today. Or imagine you could print the whole bus structures or on the train side front mass in one piece. This is completely new possibilities which are available with this new machine.
Possibility of having monolithic parts is very important sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Christopher. Thank you to everyone. And see you to next chat.
Thank you for your visit, and thank you all.
Thank you, Christopher.